Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Scarcity Lifestyle, where we talk all things fitness and finance related topic. Today, I have a very interesting topic today because we just came out with some big news about Daca. And for anybody who wants to know more about that, guys, you guys are gonna wanna like, subscribe to this channel, hit that notification bell icon because we have more information coming out on later dates. Now, I came to this country in 2004, and one of the questions that I, as long as with everybody else who comes to this country, is how will we be able to work here legally and not have to do it in a sketchy way? Now, those were big questions that everybody had. However, in June 5th, 2012, President Obama came out and he said this.
Effective immediately, the Department of Homeland Security is taking steps to lift the shadow of deportation from these young people. Over the next few months, eligible individuals who do not present a risk to national security or public safety will be able to request temporary relief from deportation proceedings and apply for work authorization.
On that fateful day, he revealed what is known as the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals, or DACA for short, which is the program that has now helped protect over 800,000 kids who came here illegally to this country and now have the opportunity to work and even have opportunities of education far beyond what they could have had before. Since 2017, actually, there hasn't been any availability for new applicants to be able to submit their forms. However, on Friday, December 4th, a federal judge came out and ordered the restoration of the DACA program, which means that new applicants can now be able to submit their form. For if they weren't able to do it before, they are able to do it now. Now, I've been a DACA recipient since before they closed it, and thankfully, I still am one to this day, and I do get the option to renew it. However, if you're applying for the first time, I want to give you some tips that helped me get it, because fun fact, I actually applied for it twice. The first time, all the paperwork was done. However, the person who helped out did not do that good of a job, and I wasn't approved because there's just some certain stuff that I'm going to tell you guys that really helped me. But the second time, I got to this lawyer and he helped me out perfectly, and I want to give you guys the exact same information. So why don't we go follow along? But before continuing, I do want to mention this. I'm not a lawyer of any chance. Do not take my word. Go find yourself a legal lawyer, someone who can actually help you out and fill out your paperwork, because although I'm giving you my tips and my perspective, I am not filling it out for you. You're gonna want to seek some professional help. So what do I need? What is it that you will need in order to be able to apply for this? First of all, you need to be under the age of 31 as of June 5th, 2012. So if you're under age of 31 by then, and if you are physically present in the United States, you will be able to apply for this. The another thing is that you must have at least been 15 years of older when applying to get your DACA. So anybody 15 and 14 and under will not be able to apply. You have to be 15 and up. The next thing that they ask is that you are either in high school, that you have completed high school, or your GED, which is your General Education Development Certificate, which will show them that you have came here and that you have taken some sort of education. And that's what they really want for, because this is more for the people getting an education. If you have any of this, you will be able to apply. Now, when you go to your lawyer, they're gonna have you fill out three forms, which are gonna be right here. Now, while filling these forms, there is a fee that the USCIS does take. For example, I think it's about $380. Go to what is the actual application process, and another $85 for what is the biometrics, which is your fingerprints and the photo that they take of you, which is about $465 in total. So that's something that you want to probably save up for if you haven't done it already. And while filling out these applications, they will ask you for evidence that you are in fact under the age of 31 or over the age of 15. And they're gonna ask you for stuff like that. So what are they gonna ask you first? First, they're gonna ask you for proof of age. So what are you gonna be able to provide with that? You can either provide a California ID, or wherever you are from watching this, you'll be able to provide your state ID. You'll be able to either provide your birth certificate or your California driver's license if you already drive. You can present any one of these documentations to be able to show that you are of age to do this. The next thing that they're gonna ask proof of is that you have been in the United States since June 5th, 2007. That is a while, I know, but they're gonna ask for proof of that. And the best way to do it is by either bills that they have sent to your house. So what you guys can do is you can go to the electric company and look it up under your parents' name, and there they will be able to ask for maybe the receipt from way back in the day. They'll be able to send it to you guys through an email. You'll be able to use that documentation as proof of evidence that you have been here in the United States. It's basically like proof of address that you'll be able to present with that. And then they're gonna ask for proof of school and or graduation. So like I said before, your transcripts, or you can show them your report card, or you can present what is your diploma or your GED certificate. Those will be able to be received by the USCIS to prove that you were here in the United States and that you are studying here. Now what happened to me, the reason why I wasn't applied for is because I was missing a lot of the key information. For example, I wasn't showing proof of all these things. The guy who told me said you need to show proof. You have to have the more the better. So that means it's not just, oh, show one thing and you'll be good. If you can get all the stuff that I just told you all together and show that as proof, that's even more evidence. You're compiling your evidence and they really like that. As well as you have to constantly be following up with the USCIS. So they're going to give you a phone number that you're gonna be able to call. So every like other week, or every week actually, you're gonna want to be calling them and be saying, I want to know the status of my application. And you just keep calling, you just keep calling. What that will show them is that there's a sense of urgency, and they're gonna always, every time you call, it gets registered, it gets put into the application. The first time, I went about 6-7 months without doing a single call, and when I finally called in, they're like, oh, sorry, we tried to contact you, but there wasn't any response. So I guess what they try to do as well, they try to call me, but maybe the phone number was wrong. But that was also my fault because I wasn't following up on them. So whenever you also apply, you wanna be calling them. You wanna be calling them. So they have your phone number on record, and it shows how many times you've called. When they see that you really do care about this. And whenever you do that, you might think I'm bothering them. But in this case, that doesn't matter. You have to do it. That is the mistake that I did that caused me to be rejected and have to pay twice. I don't want you guys to pay twice. I want you guys to get it the first time down. So guys, when you guys are applying, I urge you, find someone who knows how to do this well. Find a good person, a good lawyer who can help you out, and or a good attorney, whoever it is, the person that's going to help you out, because they will guide you through it. And also come back to this video, rewatch it, think, do I have all those things down? And like I said, you guys can start prepping these things, because as of right now, the judge has ordered it and it will go into effect next year.
Hey guys, it's editing Carlos here, and actually at the moment of editing this, he is wrong, because as of today, December 7th, you can go to the USCIS website and actually you can apply right now and you can start sending in your applications. Guys, take advantage of this, do it now. Okay, sorry, back to the video.
The date is unclear, however, once the new president-elect comes into office, he has said that within the first 100 days, he is looking to reinstate it. So guys, your best bet right now is to, one, start preparing all of the stuff. By the stuff, I mean all the paperwork, all of the money, and start preparing yourself mentally, because once you get it, you're gonna go all out. It has to be fast. So you're gonna wanna put in the application, you're gonna wanna pay the fee, you're gonna wanna be calling, checking up on it, because the faster you do that and the more you are on top of it, the faster you'll get it done. And trust me guys, that is something that is gonna help you guys so much, because not only will it give you what is protection from deportation, but as well it'll give you a social security and a working work permit, so you can be able to work at a job legally and get the same benefits, open credit card accounts, open and apply for your first car. All of these things that are the stuff that you can get, you will be able to apply for it once you get approved for your DACA renewal. Guys, I wish you guys the very best. This is Carlos speaking to you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave it a like, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you guys for more. Take care.